So now that we have added materials to the model, being in the rendered view is really going to slow the modeling down. So you're going to want to change to either a wireframe or just a simple shaded view to do the next steps. There's a couple different ways we could make an exploded isometric. The way that I'm demonstrating here would be to select the pieces of the particular portion of the model and make a 2D view. So you can see that I've made a 2D view of the base of the site, then I've selected the floor slabs and made a 2D view of the floor slabs. And by choosing that I want to register with previous, they will sort of stack up on top of each other in a nice clean way. So you can see as I'm making them 2D, I'm adjusting them over in the top layer, which is where the 2D views go. So we're exploding them so that we see each system individually. You can see I'm starting to get the different layers. I've got a walls layer, I've got floors layer, I've got a structure layer, and I've got a site layer, and I'm beginning to space those out. You'll want to think about the order of the layers, which items should be shown closest to the site, which ones are the lightest and most delicate, and maybe they belong further up in the air. Also, which items might be good together, such as the glass and the mullions. So there's a second way to do this. There's probably many ways to do this, but I'm going to show you one other way. But before I start that, I'm going to suggest to you that you go ahead and, for this method, build some regulating lines. And I think it makes sense to have some vertical elements that show us what the relationships are between the stacked layers. And in this case, I've just decided to make some guidelines at the point locations of the structure. So I've basically got light lines of the structural center lines that are reaching up and will be kind of carriage devices for my exploded isometric. So as I started this method, I was really kind of enjoying the process. The first thing I did was to lock the base layer. So I locked the site so that I wouldn't be moving it. By locking the site, I could then just select the building. And as I slid the building vertically along the carriage lines, I simply locked different layers so that they would no longer move. So the first layer I locked was the walls, then I locked the glass, then I locked the mullions, then I locked the floors, then I locked the stairs, and then finally I lifted the roof and the frame. After doing that, I went into the right side view and started to group the elements together so that they would be easy to move around and I wouldn't need to worry about that anymore. That was easier to do in a clean right side view. And then I started to combine them, again, thinking about which elements I wanted to have together as partners in the exploded axon. But I liked this method quite a bit.